Hey there.
It's 106 miles to Chicago. We got a full tank of gas, half a pack of cigarettes. It's dark, and we're wearing sunglasses.
You're gonna see some serious shit.
Hit it.
Welcome back to the Kel-n-rich Show. My name is Kel. And this is my awesome husband and musical tour guide, Rich.
Thanks, Kel. I'm going to test a theory.
Okay.
We have gone through about probably 5 hours of recording, and
it's been fun.
I've been in search of your schwinchbart, and I think I found it in groove metal, definitely southern metal, desert rock, that kind of combination. Just super heavy, powerful, doesn't have to be fast. But I'm going to test a theory here. Complete shot in the dark. Because I think, based on things like the silent lucidity breakthrough that we had on the channel, that was really the first, I would say, example of unleashing that full takeaway, you know, ethereal, progressive rock metal experience that you had. I'm curious if there's a touch of this around the southern side of things with you. Okay? Now, we have a great friend, a really good guy, Nick Tyrell. Look him up.
Hi, Nick.
We did an interview with Nick. We did a couple of his songs as first reactions and love his sound. And we wish him all the luck, all the continued success.
Yeah.
Here's an extreme example for you, and I want to see your reaction, and I'm bringing everyone along.
Okay.
This is nothing that I want to do in private and say, hey, Kel, you know, what do you think of this? And I'm not going to say any more, okay?
Okay.
I need a country sound effect.
Yee-haw!
With more blues.
Yee-haw!
Something like that.
I don't know. I'm guessing.
That's good. I'm making you work. We're just going to experience this together.
Okay.
And I'm going to just enjoy. Here we go.
Tonight, on this stage, for one night only, the Nashville Sound meets the soul of Memphis. The CMA New Artist of the Year shares a drink with his superstar buddy from the home of the blues. Get your feet, Nashville. First, Chris Stapleton, and it's Justin Timberlake.
Love Justin Timberlake.
True. Me too.
And Chris is ridiculous. So
yes.
Let's just watch this together, and we're going to talk about it.
Used to spend my nights out in a barroom. But you rescued me from reaching for the bottom and brought me back, being too far gone. Oh, that smooth Tennessee whiskey. There's nothing like your love to give me high. And you're as smooth as You're as sweet strawberry wine. You're as warm as a glass of brandy. Woo! On a icy stone, on your love all the time. And you're
now, before we go into the last song that they do, which is Drink You Away, is that also in that sphere for you of the feel of that? It's not, it's soul, but it's kind of like there's a melody and there's a groove to it.
No. And it's wonderful, and I love hearing it, and I love the sound. It's a different level. What you just played for me, Black Label Society, and what you played last night with Zakk Wylde breaking down as if he was giving a guitar lesson, that is a whole different... Like, you tell me you have a separate dessert stomach?
Yes.
Okay, I have a different music stomach. I have different music stomachs. This is wonderful, and I love it, and I would love to see them. I love Justin Timberlake. Chris Stapleton, I've heard of, not heard.
This is the first time listening to Chris Stapleton.
Heard his name. I've known that he is epically talented, and definitely, 100%.
And his wife is there, Morgan. She's the singer on All the Way on the Road.
Oh, that's fun. Mm-hmm. But it doesn't resonate through my entire... It doesn't blow my musical brains out mm-hmm. the way the last songs did, if that makes sense.
Yeah, to yeah, because we get a lot of questions about country, and you know, you're gonna branch out to country, and you know, more of a you know up tempo. You know, modern, and I figured, God, what is a great example of feel, of groove, of just wall of sound, you know, all these things that you talk about. That's why I'm testing this. And it's good to know that you like it. It just doesn't blow your doors off. This blows my doors off.
How? Why? How?
Oh, my God. It's the cohesiveness of the sound that... You know, I was a trumpet player, right? To pull off what they're doing here in this live performance, it transcends genres. It's like you got Justin's Memphis sound, you got Chris Stapleton and where they come from, and then you have this incredible like gospel church soul thing going on, and then you have the horns. The soaring horns. And then in the middle of that, you have this Justin Timberlake, like smooth as silk singing, right? Mm-hmm. That's just sexy, badass, you know, Justin Timberlake, I think it, you know, at his best, arguably. And it just, it's such a full experience that I can listen to this song over and over and over again and never get tired of it.
Interesting.
It's got so much heart and love and feel and...
It does, yet there's something missing. For me.
I get it.
For me.
I get it. That's
that
why
I'm
doing this. This was the experiment.
Not that I'm saying that the music is flawed or that the music is missing anything.
No, for you. This is all about your reaction.
That's missing Good. Something. I'm looking for a certain ingredient musically, and what we just listened to had it all.
Yeah, she's talking about we did...
I don't even know the
name. We did Black Label Society. Yeah. First started with Suicide Messiah. Then we went to
third
Bleed
one.
For Me. And then Stillborn with Ozzy.
Right. And so the last one, the Stillborn song, mm-hmm. that blew me away musically, for sure.
Mm. And of the three, that one.
That was I the loved one. Them all. But that third one, there's something...
Okay, we'll listen to
that
in the car
on the way
today to
Thanksgiving
dinner.
Not detracting from the amazingness of this ensemble at all. Mm-hmm. I can't articulate it more clearly. Sorry.
I think it's kind of gritty and kind of soulful and stuff, but it's missing.
It's just not enough.
Not enough. That's that hedonist in you. Okay, let's go with Drink You Away.
Okay.
This is, again, let's just see how it lands on you.
Okay.
Nashville! How you feeling tonight?
Oh. Keith Urban's a fanboy.
A dream, or just the same nightmare that keeps me away. My brain, sick, small shot of pain. Hey, pulling out now for the love that we made. And I feel it in the morning. Ooh, you're still here in the morning. I see you, but you're gone. Telephone,
those doctor. Keyboard grabs. Amazing. No.
This skin.
He had more to say. And so does he.
I just had an epiphany.
Epiphanatus erecti enters the building.
So this music I feel in my body.
Hmm.
But there are sounds that I am familiar with from my own musical journey. I've played in extremely big bands, orchestras, symphonies. I've had big sound around me, but it wasn't exactly like this. What you played for me with Black Label Society, I don't even know how to classify some of those sounds musically. They're new. And so maybe that's part of what's going on, is what you just played with me, Justin Timberlake and Chris Stapleton. And it was amazing and loved it. Made my heart soar to hear those sounds. Beautiful, fantastic, outstanding. Not enough words to describe how great they are. But again, I am familiar with that. I am familiar with soul. I am familiar with gospel. What you played for me, I don't even know where to start. I don't even know what it's called. I don't even know how to group musically the Black Label Society songs. That's probably what I think it is it's sounds I've never heard. I actually stopped the music in the middle of the song.
I was going to say, when's the last time we did that?
We don't, because you and I agree that we don't want to do that because we want to hear the whole song, but I just couldn't, because it was musically blowing my mind. Ah, there it is. It's musically blowing your mind versus just feeling the music and loving it in your body. I think that's what's happening, is the sound of Ozzy and Zakk Wylde, and when you've played for me songs that I've never heard. Well, the first time we listened to the song Walk.
Mm-hmm. Pantera, yeah.
Right, by Pantera. That was the first time I heard Dimebag ever play.
Yeah, and his tone and his sound and his melodies and his everything is totally appealing to you, hands down.
Right.
Like, you've never said, oh, God, turn that off, or oh, too screechy, or too groovy. Because the genres that are listed for Black Label Society, heavy metal, southern metal, mm-hmm. groove metal, and biker metal, which is a new one for me. Yeah, I mean, that's the whole, you know, that's their angle's a bad word, but you know, everybody knows what I mean. So, yeah, I think it's the groove metal that gets you. The groove metal certainly gets me. I mean, that to me, that's a sweet spot. Now, you talk about Dream Theater and all that Degent stuff and even the Soen stuff and all stuff that have been popular on the channel for
which
us.
Which I love.
Yeah. It has elements of groove, but it's not straight up in your face, 100 million flying hot tons of groove metal falling upon your head and decimating your soul so that you feel it for the next 30 lifetimes. Because that's what it is. Sorry. I'm riffing. That's what I feel, though. You know, that's what it's just like. It overtakes me, you know, when listening to really fantastic, well-arranged, well-engineered groove metal. To me, that is the best. When you get a scream or a growl put over that, that's where I tend to get lost.
If it's an accent, like, a few times, fine. But sure. When it's an entire song...
Yep.
It ceases to be a musical element and becomes the main voice, mm-hmm. or the main feature. It's okay if it's dashed in there once in a while, like a sprinkle of this and a sprinkle of that. But I just can't do an entire song like that.
Well, you can. You're just not going to like it. It's like throwing a cat in a bathtub to wash her.
It already gives me a headache just thinking about it.
So. Someone gets scratched. Unless there's going to be a country crossover that has a bit of groove, you kind of get what Kel's driving at now. We're probably not going to select it, or, you know, I'll sample it and I may show it to Kel, and she might just go, I don't want to trash this artist. I just don't want to listen to this. So, but I'm trying to reel in your sweet spots so that we chisel down from like 7 million songs right. to maybe like 100,000.
Well, and it's not that I don't like country. There's a lot of country I Absolutely. Do
Me
love.
Too. Me too.
But it borders. So here's the line. There's a lot of songs out there that are nice and they're great and they make me smile. And then there's songs that just hit you in the feels. And then there's songs that blow your mind. I'm looking for the blow the mind category. Hmm. Because we know I can get emotional. I mean, look what happened when I listened to Mr. Blue Sky for the first time. I mean, I got emotional that there was an orchestra in there. And it was amazing, and it's still my ringtone, and it's going to be my ringtone forever, because I love that song. It makes my heart sing, makes my soul dance.
It's part of your day. It's part of your day.
And it blew my mind, and Silent Lucidity blew my mind. Black Label Society blew my mind. Soen, Dream Theater, there's so Devin Townsend. I mean, there's so many of them.
Yeah, and we list things that are top of mind. Again, you guys, we kind of recycle through some of the same stuff, but it gives you an idea of like the apex of the genre, and then there's tons of other examples that fall from that.
Okay, just like so, Led Zeppelin.
Yeah, apologize for bringing up the same bands and artists over and over again.
And my repertoire is still quite small.
Yeah, and this is not an encyclopedia-type channel, you know, so we're just trying to... We're trying to understand and connect and be clear about certain things. And I'm always looking for, it's almost like a drug now. It's like, what's going to blow Kel's mind? You know, it's kind of a fun game. And if it doesn't blow your mind, I don't want to be disappointed. I don't want these guys to be disappointed. It's just going to be like, I liked it. I thought it was great music. And I don't know that it'll go on a playlist. And I wouldn't mind if I never listened to that song again in my life. You know, whatever you're going to say. But it's an interesting time that we're in right now for you, because you are able to listen to music again through the headphones. You are able to sit down for a while. So bring on your suggestions, you guys. I might pick it out. Kel might pick it out. I might give a list to her to sample some stuff. We're just going to see how things go here. Yeah. All right. So keep doing what you're doing. We're not ignoring you. We read it pretty much everything, all the comments on every video that we release for about a week, and then we have to move on. But we still go back, because I have a running list of all the comments that were from the last hour. And I just click on my little YouTube studio and I read all your comments. I show them to Kel. We respond as we can. And we're just having a great time doing this. So thank you for being part of it.
Thank you. Remember,
subscribe if you want to know when our videos are. I have to say this in every
video.
You do. I found out that even my friends that were, you know, liking the show, they're like, you guys haven't really done anything in like 2.5 years. We're back. You didn't know that we're back? No, how would I know that you're back? Were you going to call me? No, you subscribe, and then you hit the bell. So you hit subscribe, then you go over to the little bell, you press the bell, and then it says all personalized or other. And then you hit all, so that means anything we do, you'll get a notice about it. Okay?
Yeah, I wasn't even subscribed properly to my own channel.
I'm just going
to
keep doing this for a while because...
Okay.
Right. No graphics, just listen to what I'm saying.
Wishing you all a very happy Thanksgiving.
Yeah, and if you're watching this 30 years from now, hope you've had 30 great Thanksgivings.
Yes.
And you're keeping the music alive just by being you and by listening to what moves you.
Thanks for being here. So much fun today and last night. More.
Us. Hedonist. Hedonist.
Can't help it.
Bye.
Bye.
We happy? Yeah, we happy.